That intro was really weird. Is that gonna be in the video?
Yeah, just keep going.
Introducing the Behringer JT 4000 Micro. Too sure what that was about. I think the marketing team need to tweak that concept a bit more. Ooh, I've got one. The big things in life mean nothing without the small pleasures. Well, the little pleasures. The mini pleasures? The teeny tiny... Okay, so the JT4000 is the first synth of the Behringer Micro line. It's a four-voice hybrid synth with two analog modeling oscillators per voice, and it's inspired by the classic Roland synth of the mid-90s, the JP8000. Notable users included one of my favorites, the Crystal Method, as well as Ken Ishii, Goldie, Prodigy, Groove Armada, Faithless, and the list goes on. So the JT4000 Micro features two oscillators with six waveforms and an additional two-operator FM engine. It has a triangle wave, a square wave, a PWM, a saw wave, the infamous super saw wave, and a noise wave. And one of the really nice touches to the synth is that it's got an authentic 12-bit DAC to really give it that extra bit of vintage mojo. It's got 32 built-in presets, and you can of course create and save your own. And the memory is expandable via the SynthTribe app. So looking at the front panel, you can see it's powered by USB-C connection, which also gives you USB MIDI connectivity. And next to it, there's the on-off switch. And it can also be powered by smartphone or power bank when you're on the move. Pretty cool. Then you've got the volume control and a 3.5mm output connection, which also doubles as a headphone jack. Then below that, you've got a really fat sounding analog filter. And then you've got the six function buttons to access the settings for the two oscillators, the dual LFOs, individual envelopes for filter and VCA, then also the built-in arpeggiator, and lastly, the global settings. And it's worth noting that all parameters are controllable via MIDI CC. And then finally, there's the 16-key touch-sensitive keyboard and a high-resolution OLED display to view the parameters and also that cool little waveform scope. So the final points that are definitely worth a little mention are that it's also a velocity sensitive synth and it has onboard ring modulation. So now let's get to the part I'm sure you've all been waiting for. I've been Patrick, this has been the JT4000 Micro. Catch you in the next one. Peace. We'll be right back.
Thank you.